The Ridout, you're part of a process now of governments playing catch-up on infrastructure. They failed. This is infrastructure that they've really failed to deliver on in past years. How do you score the state of the nation now to meet the needs of the future, given its past record?
Look, I think there's no doubt that we underinvested in infrastructure, economic infrastructure such as the big port rail, road projects, energy grids, water. Across the board, we had a very big fixation on not running deficits. So the easiest thing to cut was capital spending. At the same time, population was growing, the economy was growing, the need was growing. We had that problem. On the social infrastructure side, like education, we were having a catch-up on schools maintenance. It was a disaster. We've had a real underinvestment in education, not only in the physical side, I might add, but on the actual level of education. And we've got big skill gaps in Australia, which is a real problem for our growth going forward. Across the board, I think we really did underinvest. Now, what's in place now, I think, is a much better process to deal with it going forward. We've yet to deliver on that, but it is in place. Infrastructure Australia seeks to take a national approach to what our infrastructure needs are rather than a states-up approach. There'll always be that balance, but for the first time, we're putting in place a process which prioritises projects in terms of their productivity, in terms of their contribution to sustainability, a whole prism of things. So that's very important. In the other areas, like the tax review, what we have to do is not look to the next election, but to the next generation. And all these investments of time and planning will take time to deliver, but we badly need to make them if we're going to improve our scorecard.
Do you have a sense that we've got an overarching population policy in this country?
Look, population policy is not just about numbers.
It's
about the structure.
Well, that's what I mean, because it's
two different issues. I mean, we've got about 870,000 or so people over 80 in Australia at the moment. By the year 2050, we'll have 2.7 million Australians over the age of 80 on current projections. I mean, you think of this. The next apology to Australians will be made to people in nursing homes if we don't match this aged care issue very carefully. As well, we have a shrinking population. You know, we're going to halve the number of the dependency ratio.
So hang on, when you say we've got a shrinking population, we're talking about a growing
workforce, right, within the population. Yeah. It'll halve in terms of, you know, over the next little while. So those people are going to have to support many, many older people, more older people. So we're going to have to work out all of that. So in terms of the demands on the public purse, they're going to rise. They're going to have to be dealt with efficiently and as smartly as we can. And we just need to keep growing the cake, otherwise, you know, we're going to have lower standards of living.
Brendan.